Hello students, my name is Sonam Maurya and I am going to teach you science. The book which we are going to follow is Science Booster. So, let's see what is our first chapter. Our first chapter is Preparation of Food in Plants. Okay, so tell me students, who makes food for you at home? Yes, your mother makes food at home. What she has made today, can you tell me? Yes, she has made rice, chapati, sabzi, and she has given you some fruits, milk, yes or no? Yes. So, today we will study how this food is prepared. Who prepares this food which we are eating? Okay. So, you told me that your mother has made chapati for you. So, have you ever seen how chapati is made? The chapati is made from wheat flour, which we call as atta. And that atta is obtained by grinding the wheat. And the wheat comes from wheat plants. The wheat plants give us wheat. And that wheat is grinded to make wheat flour. And then wheat flour is mix with water and from that we make chapati. Yes or no students? So, the chapati that you are eating is obtained from wheat plants. Similarly, the brinjal or potato that are used to make sabzi are cut and then cooked and then the sabzi or curry is made. The rice that you are eating after cooking and boiling, that rice is also obtained from rice plant. The apple plant gives you apple, which is eaten by humans, animals and birds. We all eat apples. Humans also eat apples, animals, birds, or all the fruits that are on the plants that are eaten by humans, birds, other animals also. The mango plant that gives you mangoes to eat. And that mangoes can be eaten by animals, animals, humans and birds. So you can see that everything is obtained from plants. Wheat is obtained from wheat plants. Potato, brinjal is obtained from potato or brinjal plants. Rice is obtained from rice plant. Apple is obtained from apple plants. Mangoes is obtained from mango plant. Your mother only cooks them and gives you to eat. Who is actually making or preparing the food for you? They are the plants. We are only cooking them or eating them raw. Okay, now you told me that you also drink milk. So, how you get milk? You get milk from cow. And what does cow eat? Cow eats grass. Grass is also a plant. The grass is eaten by cow. Then the cow gives you milk. And we humans drink that milk and get energy. So, you see, animals also get their food from plants. So, who is preparing the food for all of us? Animals, humans, everybody is getting their food from plants. Now, see this flowchart. Plants, we are getting wheat, rice, potato, tomato, apple, banana, grapes. That means all the fruits and vegetables from plants. We are humans are eating that plants. In this way, grapes, banana, potato, animals are also eating these plants. Cow, goat, buffalo, all these animals can eat these plants. They are giving you milk and that milk is we are drinking that milk. So, each one of us is dependent on others. We human beings are dependent on plant, animals are dependent on plants and human beings are dependent on animals also for their food. And actually the food that we are eating, the animals are eating is prepared by plants. Okay. Okay students, so now you know that the plants make the food for all of us. The animals, humans get food from plants. But have you ever thought where the food is made in plants? Who makes food in plants? So I'm going to tell you that the green leaves make food for plants. So you know now where the leaves, where the plants make food? They make the food in leaves. Leaves are called the food factories of plants. So, because the food is made in the leaves, so leaves are called the food factories of the plant. Okay, now, so leaves are very important because the food that the plant is making is prepared in the leaves. So we will discuss about structure of leaf. Have you seen a leaf, students? Yes, you have seen. Okay, we will see the leaf in a diagram. Can you see? This part of the leaf which joins the stem and the leaf is called leaf stalk. This whole leaf, the flat part of this leaf is called leaf blade. The middle portion of this leaf, which you can see, this is called leaf midrib. This is called midrib. And the other veins, these are called the veins that are coming out from the midrib. The tip or end of the pointed end of the leaf is called leaf apex. Okay, now we will see the parts of leaf on the actual leaf, real leaf. So students, can you see these leaves? This is a mango leaf, this is a guava leaf, and this is some other plant's leaf. So, if you see, this is called the leaf stalk. This is called the leaf stalk. This is called the midrib. You can see this midrib, it is running, cutting the leaf into two equal parts. This is called the midrib. These small, small veins, these are called the veins that are coming from the midrib. And this tip is called the leaf apex, and this whole leaf, flat leaf, is called leaf plate. This is another leaf. You can see the midrib here, you can see the veins here, you can see the leaf stalk, you can see the leaf apex here. See this leaf also, you can see this. This is the leaf stalk, this is the midrib, these are the veins which are going, this is the leaf apex. And this is the flat part of the leaf is called the leaf blade. Students, that now you know the structure of leaf. This is called leaf stalk, leaf blade. These are called veins. This is midrib and this is leaf apex. Now we are going to study about xylem and phloem. What are xylem and phloem? Okay, so what you are seeing here as the flat part, the midrib, the vein, these are actually tubes which carry water and food in plants. Okay, have you ever seen the water that comes to your house, from where it comes? Yes, it comes through pipes to your overhead tank, and from that tank it comes through to your taps. Similarly, there is a pipeline system or tube like system in plants which carry food and water to different part of plants. Okay, the tubes that carry water from roots to the leaf is called xylem. There are tubes that will carry water from the roots to the leaves. They are known as xylem. And phloem, these are the tubes that carry food from leaves to other part of plants. The tubes that carry food from leaves to other part of plants are called phloem. Okay, to understand xylem and phloem more easily, let us look at this picture. See, you can see this diagram. The roots, they are in the soil and they are also in the form of tubes. The water is present in the soil. This water goes from these roots through these tubes upwards. And these tubes which carry the water from the roots to all the parts. This water is carried from roots to the leaves, to the veins, to the midrib. You can see this, the blue colored lines, dotted lines show that water is going from the soil to the leaves through xylem tubes. The water is going from the roots to the leaves, all the leaves, all the part of plants through the xylem tubes. These xylem tubes carry water from the roots to the leaves. Okay, now phloem. You know that food is prepared in the leaves. The leaves are called the food factory. So the other parts of the plant also need food to grow. So this phloem, the tubes known as phloem, the food which is prepared in the leaves, these tube called phloem, they take them to other parts of the plant. They take them to the stem and the roots. They take them, the food from the leaves to stem, roots and other parts of plants. So xylem is a tube. Xylem are the tubes which carry water from roots to the leaves and other parts of the plant. and phloem are the tubes, and phloem are the tubes which carry food which is prepared in the leaves to other parts of the plant. So are you clear what is xylem and what is phloem? Okay.